is Ali Azeem from Ali Azeem Services, and today's video is much awaited video because this is the topic of the day, and all the way from New South Wales, from Sydney, especially from Australia, you are listening some separate news, you know, as far as northern beaches of Sydney are concerned. And actually, they are the cause of another cluster of the COVID-19 cases. Victoria closes the borders for the Sydney passengers. And when it comes to New South Wales, when it comes to Adelaide, they are closing the border, or rather they have closed the borders for the New South Wales passengers. What is happening right now? This is the video all about the recent COVID attack in the Sydney. So can it affect or can it impact on the international passengers? This is the topic today. But before I start speaking on the video, this is a request to please subscribe the channel. And this will be so much important to go on my Facebook page. That is an official Facebook page. A link is in the description. You can follow that page and you can have the update on the upcoming videos. And all the universities, you guys are going to apply. This is the only channel in South Asia that leads you towards the perfection, and you can really get a real news out of this channel. And that's why this is going to be important to subscribe it, and this is going to be important to share this video to all other friends and the family. Let's come to the video, and I want to ask one question to you. I mean, if you have a problem back in your home, let's say if I have a problem back in my home, how could it impact, you know, outside in the street? Never. See, this is purely an internal matter of Australian government. This is the domestic matter of the Australian government. It is not going to impact on international traveling. So international traveling plan is still over there. So Australian government, whatever they are planning, so it's been last 1 week, I'm on to the conferences, I'm on to the seminars, and I'm onto the press releases and the kind of media talks, obviously. And I was listening to PM Morrison, I was listening to all the people who are related to the borders opening and the decision makers and all the tall bodies when it comes to Australian borders. None of them is claimed that the international community is going to be impacted out of this, you know, outbreak in the Sydney. So let me tell you that don't speculate the things, be focused. You know that in Sydney, in the northern beaches, some cases emerged over there, like first day 30 cases, and then 60, then 75. And today's news, when I'm making this video, so today 95 cases in Sydney, I mean, they were merged. And of course, one Sydney passenger traveled to Victoria, and I was listening the press release of, this was the press release of the Victorian government that there is only one COVID case today. I mean, as of 22nd of December, 2020. So let me tell you one thing here, that Victorian government, they have imposed the ban on the Sydney passengers, actually the northern Sydney, greater Sydney passengers. So Adelaide Airport, they've announced that the Sydney passengers cannot enter in Adelaide, Canberra, obviously, and Western Australia as well. So you see, this is purely their domestic affairs. I mean, it has nothing to do with the international traveling. So you got to keep this fact in your mind. Whatever they have announced from the international point of view, the international flights are going to be there, but they're waiting for the Christmas. But this Christmas is really an affected Christmas, let me tell you. This Christmas is not going to be a normal and the usual Christmas as you witnessed last year, or you will witness in the future in the upcoming years in 2021 or 2022. So, but make sure that the Victorian border, I mean, they have, you know, employed 700 policemen on the road borders, of course, that nobody can enter to Victorian state from the New South Wales. I mean, similarly, when it comes to the quarantine, actually, the New South Wales state government, they've announced the quarantine, that the people should quarantine on their hubs, on their accommodations. And they have also I mean, set a fine for the people who just, gather, actually more than 10 people. Once more than 10 people gather in the house or outside in the restaurant, there is a fine now. And the individual fine is 500 Audis, Australian dollars. And when it comes to the business, I mean, if somebody opens the business until the further notice of the government, there is $5,000, fine. But let me tell you that again, keep it in your mind that this restriction is not for the international community. This is purely a domestic problem for the Australians, and it has nothing to do with the international traveling. Let me clarify for once and all that the international traveling is on the mood. So the people were just spreading the rumors and the news on the different platforms. Actually, you know, it's an era of the social media. It's an era of the print media, electronic media. So whatever news strikes, you know, whatever news strikes over there, it doesn't mean that is the right news. And people are really making a complete story after listening headline only. Don't read the headlines only. I mean, you got to go to the details of that headline if you want to make some final conclusion. And let me clarify one thing once again. Be composed, be focused, and this is so much important to be determined in this difficult time. This actually is the time you can reveal your potential, your potentiality. Everybody can live in the easiest time. Everybody can spend time in the easiest time. But when it gets harder, when the harder time comes, this is the time for the learning. Be patient. And believe you me that the time is coming for the international borders. Australia cannot keep the international community away from Australian borders for long. Thank you very much, Ali Azeem, and keep smiling and subscribe this channel. This is so much important.